Aiming is one of the single most important aspects of Fortnite, especially if you want to improve your fighting skills on controller. So many players focus way too much on how fast they can edit and build, and while it might look pretty cool, it ain't worth jack if they can't close out the fight with good aim. What's up, Fortnite fam? I am Cody, and today we are going over the best tips and tricks that will allow you to become an absolute monster on the sticks. So hit that sub button and let's get into it. If you want to become a god on a controller, then one of the things that you're going to have to do is put the time in. No one can come out of nowhere and suddenly be the best. That just doesn't work. So you're going to need to put some practice time in. Every pro player will grind out Fortnite for more than 6 hours every single day, and training their aim and mechanics before they drop into scrims will be a huge part of their daily routine. Practicing is easy. It's something every player does by just playing the game. But being efficient while doing it is what will separate the top tier pros from the average players. What you need to do is start off in creative and load up some aim training maps, preferably Scavox. To this day, Scavox is probably the best aim training map in Fortnite, and it'll help you improve any and every aspect of your aim. You should aim to run each scenario a couple of times, and try to do that for around half an hour to 45 minutes every time you play. This will help you realize your strengths and weaknesses, and will also allow you to figure out what exactly you need to practice the most. What you need to remember is that you aren't an aiming god, not yet, and there are going to be things that you need to change, so don't be overconfident. After training your aim in a creative map, hop onto some arena solos and push up against every single player that you see. Aim training maps are well and good, but they're nothing compared to realistic scenarios actually in a game. You'll automatically notice what you're doing better and what costs you in fights. Every time you lose a fight, look back at it in your replays, and if it was because you actually missed your shots, then you'll know exactly what you need to train next. If you are struggling to land shots on your opponents even after you've practiced a whole bunch, then you should head over to ProGuides.com. We've got a ton of pro coaches ready and waiting 24/7 to help you out. They'll tell you exactly where you're going wrong and will push you forward to be the best Fortnite player that you can be. One of the major flaws that almost every player notices while playing on controller is how precise their crosshair placement is. Many players use controller will have trouble flicking and constantly hitting their shotgun shots. This might seem pretty easy on keyboard and mouse. Precise aim movements are of course much easier to do since you have much finer control, but on controller, it takes much more effort to master. When you're playing controller, it's gonna be all about playing steadily and tracking your opponents at all times. Many players have trouble winning their fights and think that being fast and twitchy is better than playing slowly, but that's definitely not the case. Haven't you heard the story of the tortoise and the hare? You need to make sure you can track your opponent while keeping your crosshair on the enemy's head. This is going to allow you to hit your opponent incredibly hard, allowing you to eliminate them quicker than ever before. One of the next most important steps to having some of the best aim on controller is having a good sensitivity. Playing on the default settings really isn't a good idea, so if you haven't switched off them, already know it is definitely the time. Chapter 2, Season 6 is going to reward having a good sensitivity, mainly because we currently have the pump shotgun in the loot pool. The pump rewards very good aimers and really shows why having optimal sensitivity is so essential. We have a full video going over the best sensitivity and controller layouts, so if you want an in-depth explanation, you should go and watch that video. All you really need to know, however, is that you should be using a medium sensitivity so that you can easily maneuver around but still be accurate with your shots. But that's only for your normal sensitivity. Your building sense should be totally different. Having a high edit and build sensitivity is incredibly good and will help you way more than you expect. Even if you have a slow look sensitivity, you can actually just switch to edit mode to turn faster. This allows you to move around quicker and will not force you to turn your look sensitivity higher. Make sure you check out our previous controller settings video if you're having trouble finding the perfect sensitivity. Finally, just make sure you practice with your new sensitivity and make sure you never miss another shot. Alright Fortnite fam, it is the question of the day time. We want to know how high you've managed to climb so far in the season. Are you in champions yet, or are you still struggling to climb out of the open league? Let us know in the comments below because we will read every single one. Now that we've gone over sensitivity, we're going to go a little more in depth on which mode is going to help you abuse your aim assist to the maximum. If you're playing on controller, then this season you're probably going to need to be on linear mode. It's much better for being up close and personal, and will help you either beam your opponents with an SMG or primal rifle, and help you hit every single shotgun shot. Linear is definitely something every controller player should be using. The only issue is the long range aim, which will be pretty difficult when using this mode. Linear is all about tracking things close range. Luckily, that's where the majority of fights happen this season because of the lack of things like snipers and the lack of first shot accuracy on all primal weapons. Exponential mode is much worse for close range fights, and at the moment, it is nowhere near as powerful as a controller player than linear. The aim assist is a little bit weaker, and it's going to force you to play much more defensively than if you were using linear. Exponential is better for defensive players and players who get their surge tags with rifles rather than taking early game fights, which is much harder to do in Chapter 2 Season 6. If you're the sort of player who wants to go for long range tracking, then this will help you hit more shots, but that's less of an option in this season. So we really recommend that you switch to linear so that you can win more of your fights. Long range aiming is one of the biggest problems that every controller player has, and sometimes it just feels impossible to hit shots from more than 75 meters. This is definitely one of the biggest cons of the controller, as there is pretty much nothing you can do to really improve on it. Using a joystick for extremely fine movements is definitely a challenge, but it's also the reason you need to practice. Try to never be demotivated by things like these, and instead, just use it as a way to improve. Even if you're having a lot of trouble hitting your shots from long ranges, work on improving your tracking and simply try your best. Having solid tracking on controller will help you abuse spray weapons, especially with aim assist on your side. Now, when it comes to any weapon in Fortnite, there are two things that you need to learn how to master if you want to take someone out. And not on a date, I'm talking out, to the grave, adios muchacho. So what do you need to know? You need to know how Bloom works and how to control the recoil of the weapon you're using. This has become even more important in Season 6 due to the addition of makeshift and primal rifles. None of those weapons have first shot accuracy, so you're only going to be relying on your Bloom and recoil control to get eliminations. All rifles have Bloom, and it will be the primary reason that you miss shots with a rifle even if you're managing to track your opponent perfectly. Instead of just holding down the trigger when you're firing at an enemy, you should try firing and timing your shots. For example, if you spray your opponent and notice that none of your shots are hitting, you shouldn't keep spraying. Instead, you should fire off bursts of bullets, holding the trigger down for a second and then releasing it. If you do this, your Bloom won't grow as much as if you were just holding the trigger down, meaning there is a higher chance for you to land your shots. And of course you can always practice this. Go into aim training maps or in modes like Zone Wars. Just remember that Bloom is still luck-based. So even if you're managing the Bloom, there's still a chance that you'll pull some bad RNG and miss your shots anyway. The point of Bloom and recoil management is that those RNG situations will happen less and less. Basically, just remember the next time you're having bad Bloom, stop spraying your weapon, reload, and then burst fire to keep things under control. Just by changing up how you shoot your weapon, your AR aim will suddenly be much better. It'll also have the added benefit of confusing your opponent, leading them to peek out even more than usual. Peekaboo, boom! Bye-bye. Having good aim on any input is very important, and we hope this video will help you become the best aimer that you can. Just remember to consistently practice and use every tip and implement it into your playstyle. Speaking of which, you can always check out the rest of our channel for more tips and tricks. And if you found this video helpful, make sure to like the video and sub with the bell on. That's it for today though, so best of luck on the battlefield, y'all. I'll catch you in the next one. Peace.